desert. Desert is compared to a person having a cavernous mouth. Cavernous mouth means a mouth which was wide like a cave, open mouth. So you know desert is a very wide, so its mouth is not very small like a human's mouth, it was a wide mouth, so it is compared to a cave. And also the hungry desert lion. And also Hagar is describing this desert as very hungry. Actually desert is an inanimate thing, but there is a personal feelings are attributed to it. So she feels that this desert is already very hungry. So this hungry desert is opening its mouth in order to swallow this mother and baby, and that may be why and this sand became very cold and it became very hot during the day. During the night it became very cold. So whatever may be the situation, whether it is the day or the night, and both of their condition is very horrible, they may die. And so she feels that like a human having a mouth like a cave, the desert may wanted to take the life of Hagar and Ishmael. And when you come to the next paragraph, you can see what are the care and attitude, or what is the attitude of his mother. You can see there. Now she feels, when we know that when we have enough water is not there, and we want to moisten our lips. But here Hagar is not at all doing that, because the remaining water content in her body, it may be lost if she moisten or make her lips moist. And so because otherwise the baby may not get anything from her breast. And so that also shows the motherly protection and care. And so now she is not thinking about her survival, she is thinking about the baby's survival. So that also shows Hagar's endurance, and also it shows her sacrificing mentality. She is sacrificing her wish, all whatever she wanted to do, she is sacrificing for the survival of her baby Ishmael. And that also shows the mother's sacrifice. And now a few days is already there, but she is not eating them, because if she is eating the dates, the remaining water content in her body, it may be lost. That means that may be the end of the baby. So that also shows the mother's endurance, Hagar's endurance as a mother. And when you come to the next paragraph, and now there is a description about again about the desert, and there is a long deep sigh. The dust storms continue to blow and buffer her. It is also given there. So now there is again storm is starting in the night also, and also it is continuously going on like that. And now all of a sudden, and now the night is already over, the next day started. And as you have seen in the previous paragraph already, the sun is also becoming very hot. And now you can see the sun is hiding behind the sand dunes. Sand dunes means the mountains made up of sand. So you might have seen in films or in pictures, sand dunes are not like a permanent mountain, and it will move from one place to another according to the power of the wind. And when the powerful wind is coming, and all the sand will be heaped together in one place, and in the next storm it will be coming to another direction. So it is not a permanent mountain like an actual mountain. So such mountains made up of sand is called sand dunes. And now when the powerful wind is over, already the sun is very hot. Now for some time there is a small shadow is coming. And now the sand remained like cinders of fire. That also you can note out. That is the next comparison. And the sand which is already hot from the hot sunlight, and it is like a cinders of fire. Cinders of fire is also, that is the coals of fire. It's like embers burning in the hearth or kanali bole. That is cinders of fire. And again night came. So again the day is over, next night is coming, and biting cold is given. That is is a very extreme cold is there during the night. And now already the water is already over. There is no drop of water for drinking for Hagar and Ishmael. The last drop is there. And now Ishmael started making so much noise because of her hunger and thirst. And now when we come to that paragraph, you can see the baby's voice became very weak because he also has got dehydration. There is no water, and also there is no breast milk is not there. And so when you come to the towards the end of that paragraph, you can see the baby's cry is compared to the cry of a bird, that is the kiki of a bird whose neck is being wrung. And when you take your arms around the neck of a small bird, the bird cannot produce a sound. And similarly, the baby, due to dehydration, and he wanted to cry, but the sound is not properly coming out from the mouth, from the throat. So the sound produced from the baby's mouth is very small, weak sound, like the weak sound coming from the throat of a bird when somebody is strangling on its or choking on its throat. And that is another comparison. And when we come to the next paragraph, and only small, only a few remaining drops of water is there. So what did Hagar do is, and she take the goat skin full of water, and she squeezed it, she pressed the goat skin, and then the remaining drops of water she pour into the mouth of this baby. And that is the last, that was the last drops of water for the baby survival. And then that also shows Hagar as a mother, and also her affection and care for the baby. And then some questions came into the mind of Hagar, whether she will be dying for the first time, or whether she will die first or the baby will die first. And that was the question coming into her mind. So for some time, up to this time, Hagar was so disappointed, depressed, and also she is thinking about the death and all. And her mind was filled with anxiety and fear, and also she was thinking seriously about the baby survival, etc. And all these things you can see in this coming line. And now she is thinking about if the baby is dying, and she is thinking about making a pit in the wilderness, in the desert, using her empty hands, and put the baby's dead body in that pit, etc. So that was the helplessness of this mother. And then an idea came into her mind, a very fearful idea came into her mind, or thought came into her mind. And if the baby is dying, she can bury the baby's body. But if she is dying before the baby dies, and what would happen? That made a fearful thought in her mind. Because if Hagar is dying first, and her dead body will be eaten by these vultures, you know what a vulture is, there is a bird, these birds are eating dead bodies. And when the baby is seeing the vulture is eating away his mother's dead body, what would happen his feeling? Or how this baby will survive if the mother is dying first? And that question make a shocking thought in her mind. And so she is imagining about the baby is crawling in the sand. Nobody is there to look after the baby, and also the baby's life may be in danger. And when that thought came into Hagar's mind, all of a sudden Hagar took a decision not to die, and she wanted to survive. And all of a sudden some kind of courage, strength came into her mind, and so she don't want to die at all. So a strong courage or a decision came into her mind, and that you can see in the coming lines onwards. And now Hagar, and a few paragraphs until now, we have seen a Hagar whose mind was filled with tension, worry, disappointment, distress, tension, etc. But all of a sudden, all those negative feelings are gone. Hagar got up from the sand, and now an annoying strength or a courage came into her mind, and she took a decision to survive. Anyhow, she wanted to survive, and so she understood one thing. And even though Abraham abandoned her and also her son, God made